Hey Cherubs, welcome to Dr. Uechi's Diabetery. Today we're going to be making thin mints and cream, which is one of the top 3 requests for this channel. So first we add 2 cups of half and half to a medium-sized sauce pot, and place this on medium heat. Stir frequently, and don't let it boil. Place 2/3 of a cup of granulated sugar into your mixing bowl. Just keep stirring. Next we'll need 6 egg yolks, and I'll need to figure out how to do that while holding a cell phone. Just keep stirring. We won't be using the whites, so if you're a better cook than I am, then get started on those macaroons. And if you're me, well, at least you have breakfast for tomorrow. Just keep stirring. Oh, and increase the heat a little. Add the yolks to the sugar. Because I have no forearms, we're gonna whisk them with a KitchenAid mixer until they're well incorporated. Just keep stirring. I pour the hot half and half into a jug to make it easier to pour into the mixer. Keep whisking. Hopefully you don't have too many air bubbles in the mixture or it won't fit back into your pot. Put this back on medium heat, stir frequently, and don't let it boil. Add a tablespoon of vanilla extract into the empty jug. Just keep stirring. Add 1/8 of a teaspoon of salt. I think this is about 1/8? Yeah, I know. Just keep stirring. You should feel some steam rising from the mixture, but it shouldn't be boiling. Pour the mixture into the jug with the vanilla extract and the salt, and hope that all the alcohol in the vanilla extract evaporates. Now add 2 cups of heavy cream and stir. Let the mixture cool for a bit, and stick this in the refrigerator overnight. Or at least 8 hours? You know, whichever comes second. Slowly pour the mixture into the KitchenAid freezer bowl attachment, and let it run for about 12 to 15 minutes. The attachment incorporates air into the mixture, so check back on it frequently to make sure that it's not going to spill out of the bowl. In the meantime, decide how many inches you want to add to your waist circumference. Wait, no, I mean how many thin mints you want to add to the ice cream. I usually use about 3/4 of the box. Use whatever means you like to break them into pieces. Keep in mind that you want pieces, not dust, so don't go all Dragon Ball Z on them. When the freezer bowl starts to get full, slowly add the thin mints. If you're like I am and you have the patience and maturity of a 4-year-old, you can eat the ice cream right now, and it'll taste like soft serve. Or you can put it into a container and freeze it, and it'll take on the consistency of normal ice cream. Of course, Hawaii is really hot, and I don't have air conditioning, so the ice cream melts when I try to transfer it to a new container. And yeah, when I first started making ice cream, this went on for over 1 year, until my best friend told me that I was an idiot, and that I should just put the bowl back into the freezer, let it set, and then transfer it to another container. She was like, "You went to med school, and you couldn't figure that out?" And to that I say,
"You're uninvited to my birthday party!"
Okay, so freeze it overnight, and that's it! Homemade ice cream! If you're looking for toppings to add, I strongly recommend atorvastatin,